So, how do we calculate the AI? First of all, there are a lot of ways to do AI, obviously. There are simply hard-coded ways. There are far more complex ways to do AI. You can even do binary trees. You can do whatever you want. Okay, but what I want to do in this case, or well, let's experiment with, is to create some sort of, or well, base our AI brain under the utility theory. There's a lot of videos on utility theory. The ABCs are, you have actions and you calculate a score for each action, and the highest score is going on to, yeah, it's the action you take for that interval of time. Let's say an example. Think of it, you have a field of view, okay, and you have all your actions. You have one action that is attack the enemy, and you have another action that is patrol or do whatever you are doing right now. Okay, so what do you do, how the utility theory works? First of all, you're going to go through each of your actions and calculate the score. So the attack enemy action is going to have a flag. Do you see an enemy or do you not? If you don't see an enemy, obviously the score for that action will be zero, which means the do what you already doing or the patrol action has a higher score, obviously, because the patrol action will have do you see an enemy, and if it's false, you raise more values. Yeah, you raise more points than you have to. Okay, so that means you do the same. If it changes and you see an enemy, then it switches to the new action, which is, of course, attack the enemy. Okay, now let's go and create the logic that is going to be doing all of this. So let's add a new region, and this will have to do with decisions variables. Okay. Now we need a timer. Let's say public float. We don't have this to be. Don't need to, this to be public. So let's say decision timer, and we can have a public float for decision rate. Okay. Let's assign this to 2 or 1 second. Depends. We don't have to be doing this on every frame. That's the important time. The important thing. Okay, let's encapsulate this, however, into, let's make it public, so we might want to force it from a different action to do a new recalculation. So we're going to do a public void check decisions, or calculate, actually no, handle decisions timer. Okay, let's also pass the delta, or well, we don't have to pass the delta, we have it stored as a variable. So handle decisions timer, basically decisions timer delta, if decisions timer is greater than our decision rate, reset the decision timer and back to zero. So in here we need a list or an array or whatever that will hold onto actions that will basically calculate the score for each action and decide which is the correct, yeah, which is which action has the higher value. But first, before doing that, let's go over here and pass the handle decisions timer in here before we do the current action, just in case we have to change that. Okay, so now it means we're going to have to create a state, or where the equivalent of a state, and instead of actions, it's going to have, well, instead of state actions, it's going to have logic for calculating the, you know, the scores, and then of course the action we want to output it. But let's do this under a framework as well. So inside our AI, we're going to go and create score we can put AI in front if you want. Let's say score calculation. Or we could just, yeah, okay, we can do the same thing inside our AI actions, on their own AI actions, but it's not going to make it that modular. Okay, but yeah, you will say that any AI action I want to do, it will be, yeah, it will calculate it like that. Anyway, okay. So let's just create an AI score calculation. Let's delete this. Let's add the namespace for AI. And let's add a scriptable object. This now is going to still be an abstract class. Okay. And we're going to have an abstract. This time we want to return an integer. Calculate. And pass an AI manager. Okay, because from the AI manager we can, or let's just say AI, we can pass back to the state manager and have access to any state we want. So let's create, no, we're not going to create over here, and let's say over here, let's create a new folder, let's say AI score calculations. Okay, so let's create a new folder, a new class, and let's call this enemy sighting. Okay, the easiest one of the bunch. Let's delete all of this. A space, say AI. And this one now is going to be AI score calculation. Let's implement the abstract class. Okay, so let's say on our AI, we have our variables over here. We don't really need the timer anymore, but we can still keep it. And let's say just a simple flag, public bool, has enemy. Okay, obviously we're going to have to expand a lot more on this, or we can add aggro levels, all those things. Okay, so if AI has enemy, well, first of all, let's make a return value. Let's say returns 0. If AI has enemy equals turn return R. Okay, let's create an asset menu. Menu name AI. Let's call it scores. Enemy sighting. We can actually improve this a little bit. So we're going to say public integer default value 0, positive value 10, so that I don't have to come over here every time and say and change this. Okay, a little bit more of optimization if you don't want this to be public, because there's no need to be public. Well, not really optimization, it's still the same thing, just for the editor. You can add this as a serialized field. Okay, it's the same thing like using public, so you know, whichever one you want to use. Okay, so we have this, but let's say onto our AI, onto our AI attack on interval, we go and add an AI score calculation. Let's say score calculation, or simply calculation. Okay, let's call it score calculation. Let's not be that lazy. Okay, so we have an AI score calculation. And actually, instead of adding it on the attack on the subclass, on the child class, let's add it on the superclass, which is also our base class, which means it's agnostic as to what action it is. We just need to know that it has a score calculation. So on our state manager, not on state manager, on AI manager, on our decision time, we can say, find me the AI action that find highest score AI action. Okay, let's just call it highest score action. Okay, AI action, return value or result, whatever you want to call it. Let's set it like that first. Red value, because you might not have anything. So our current action now will be find highest score action. Let's create an array for now. AI action. And say AI action, action list, actions list. So we're going to do, first of all, we're going to say value, yeah, okay. Let's say integer highest, which means for highest score, it will start from zero, and then for actions list dot length. If actions list I dot score calculation is null, skip this. Otherwise, if actions, otherwise calculate the score actually. Integer score for this action, action list I dot score calculation dot calculate and pass this. Okay, and if score is higher than the highest score we have, highest is going to be your new score right now, and of course the return value is going to be the action list I, action list I. Okay, and then we return the return value. So depending if we have now two actions, so you know what, let's say AI attack on internal, let's add public string, let's say animation name. I'm going to add a default one and pass this. Okay. Awesome. And we have our AI simulation. Okay. So let's say make sure we use this. Okay. Handle decision timer. Decision timer. Okay. Every 2 seconds might be too low. Anyway. Okay. So minimize that. Let it compile. So let's go into data, AI, let's create a new folder for actions and a new folder for scores. So AI attack on internal, let's say attack 1, and let's duplicate that for attack 2, and let's change the animation, let's pick another one, let's do one of the override things. Let's say you're going to point down for the attack 2. Okay, now both of these two now require a score. So let's go on to create and say AI scores enemy sighting. Okay, default value 0, positive value 10. Let's duplicate this just for fun. So if I do the opposite, 10 and 0, it means that if enemy sighting is false, you're going to have a score of 10. Okay, so you can do this trick so that you don't have to create new changes. So let's say true enemy sighting and false enemy sighting. just by the name, just so that by the name we can tell which is which. Okay, so on to our actions. Attack one, let's say true, enemy sighting, and attack two, fall, enemy sighting. So let's rename that. We're not that bad at spelling. Okay, false enemy sighting. So all we are left to do is go on to our enemy, and on our action list we can remove this just so that we see that it's working, and we can add attack and attack one and attack two. Now if I hit play now, the first action that is going to run is basically going to as you can understand, it's going to wait till the first rate has passed and then do the attack we want. For that to change, however, we can simply force this, find highest score action. We can do this inside start. So let's hit play. And you can see this guy attacks with one attack. Actually, yeah, because it's false, he's pointing down. But when we hit his enemy, it changes the attack animation. That's why, because the current action changes, because it has a different score than the rest. Okay. If we change this back to false, our brain calculates that the action we want to do right now is the attack one instead of attack two. Okay, this is the very, very simplest example for the utility theory. Obviously, just a flag. But instead of relying on, simple solutions, let's say we want to add a new bool over here, has enemy. And let's also say public bool is close. Okay, on our AI score calculation, or well, enemy sighting, we can say positive value. Let's do another value over here, integer, extra value. I'm just simply giving them, stupid names. I don't really, yeah, that might not work actually. So let's say if it's true, if has enemy, and if AI is close or whatever. Okay, or add an extra value. Add the extra value. So, depending on the data we have, for example, this instead of is close, you can calculate the distance, and depending on that distance, you give more score to that value. And it will calculate, basically now it turns down into creating an algorithm to find the proper score for each action. Okay, so you move from hard coding anything that has to do with your AI, basically checking, if it's close to you, all those things. Now you change all of that and make it so, yeah, it's much more simpler actually. And not only that, we can do on our AI actions, we can do a void, an abstract void, or we could basically do new actions. So for example, we can say public AI action on enter, and public AI action on exit. So what you're doing when you are changing these two actions, and for that to work on our AI manager, we can simply say AI action highest then if current action dot on exit not equals null, current action. Actually, let's encapsulate it inside our AI action. So basically say public void, void. So just so that we don't access these two, let's serialize this field. Same with this. And say on enter, not on enable, on enter. And public void on exit. So these two is going to do, if on enter not equals null, on enter, and of course we need to be passing a manager here. On enter dot tick AI. Okay, because this is an AI action, it's going to come with a few more garbage, but we don't really have to populate these two. Okay. Alternatively, we can just do simple actions or you know what. If it's that much of a problem to you, then simply do a new action and do only for that. But I think I can live with it, with just having these two. Or, yeah, or I guess we could just do another subclass. Anyway, whatever, I don't really care. So let's say public, let's do the same for exit. AI on exit, paste this, and don't forget to change this to on exit, on exit. Okay, back to the AI manager, which means current action, or well, if current action is not null, first current action dot on exit this, and current action equals highest current action dot, and actually we still check if current action is not null. Current action dot on enter this. Then with all of this, we're going to copy all of that and paste it above. Okay, so we now have specific actions that will run either when you enter or when you exit a state. So this is very similar now to what we have onto our onto our behavior node editor. Okay, but it's for AI purposes only. Also, just for the fun of this, let's say debug.log action list I plus let's say score this interval is plus the score you've calculated. Okay, so minimize that, hit play, let it compile. I don't have to add an enter or exit action into my actions, obviously. Okay, so we see that, let it run it once more. So on this interval, attack 1 is the score is 0, and attack 2 the score is 10. So obviously it plays with 10. If we change this to has enemy, it's the opposite thing. Interval now, attack 1 is 10. If we also open is close, on the next interval we'll say that because it's 15, because we are also close now, the attack is 15. And attack 2, why is it 5? It's because we have the same score calculation, and by the same score calculation, it checks we have this the opposite way. So for attack 2, the default value is 10, which means has enemy is going to be true. Positive value is going to be 0, however, because it's the opposite. And is close, it will add the extra value because it's also close, so that means it's 5. Okay. So, yeah, I think I've covered most of what I wanted to cover for this video. We did run out of time. And the idea is that on the next videos, of course, we're going to populate with all of these things we want to access and populate. And we're going to, yeah, we're basically going to be doing all those checks and all those nice things. So, we're also going to have pluggable lists of actions. So, you know, if a different state dictates that you have different actions, then it's simply going to switch, so we're not calculating actions that don't really, that aren't relevant to any of your, yeah, to the current state you are in. Okay, so yeah, that's the idea. As always, you know what to do, like, subscribe, and if you like to see more stuff like this, more cool things, more tools, and more things you can do for your games, then consider supporting me on Patreon so we can keep making all of these nice things. I'll see you next time.